Hi everybody, my name's Jason. I'm on the product design team here at Plex. Today I want to talk about a feature that's often overlooked, but is incredibly important to us, to the product, and especially our users. And that is the search experience. A lot of times, a great search experience is not even noticed because if it's working well, it stays out of the user's way. They're able to get to exactly what they want to quickly, and everyone moves on about their day. If it's not working well, it's extremely noticeable. So, some time back, we set out to look at how users were using Plex and search today versus a year ago. The results were interesting. After numerous research studies, working with the metrics team on a lot of the golden paths and the activities that people take after they search for a title, we began to realize that the behaviors are different. People are often searching for titles that are in pre-production, not even in the theaters yet, or searching for a title that's, you know, in theaters in hopes of adding it to their watch list so they can be notified when it is available or, you know, notify some third-party integration. Another big use case is people know that the title is not in one of their libraries, but they suspect it's available in another library or on one of the services available out there. Maybe it's one they subscribe to, maybe not. So as the needs for search in Plex have evolved, it was time for us to take a step back and improve that. And so through numerous design iterations focused on aesthetically simple, but still offering the power features, you know, the engineering team iterating on the heuristics and, you know, the algorithm that we use to produce the results, we're really happy to take you guys through some of the improvements and features today. Without further ado, let's jump in and I'll show you some of the improvements that have been made. So here we have two identical experiences in Plex, except the one on the right uses the old search experience and the one on the left uses the new search experience. It's probably the best way for at least to highlight some of the improvements, and then we'll look at some of the new features. So, an easy one is, let's do a quick search for John Wick. John Wick Chapter 3 shows up, top result, it's available in my media library. Unfortunately, I'm actually searching for John Wick. I want to go back and rewatch the series. And in order to see that, I actually have to scroll all the way through all of this other stuff in order to get to John Wick and more ways to watch. You can also see that John Wick Chapter 3 is duplicated here. And that's because in the old search experience, the locations were prioritized. And with fuzzy matching, that meant that sometimes we would have to get through the less relevant results to get to the more relevant results, which is just not a great experience. Now, let's compare that to the new experience. Clear this. All right, let's take a look at John Wick here. The great news is that we're still going to prioritize content that's available from your own libraries, but we can even see now that we've got John Wick, Chapter 2, and Chapter 4. So all of those titles in our top four results, which is a much better and more streamlined experience. So if I click on John Wick, awesome. I can see that it's available in a lot of places, including Peacock. We'll check that out. You can see that we have a much better experience. So next example, I can actually just focus on the new experience in this particular case, is I want to have some background TV show running while I'm gonna work on something monotonous. I'm a Bob Barker fan, so let's check out The Price is Right. Awesome, so one of the cool things that we have now is the ability to surface live TV channels. Even though I'll still see Bob Barker episodes from my own, you know, media library, I can immediately get a result for what's airing on TV right now and drill right into that result and tune into a channel. I could also view more results, and let's do Bob Barker. And the nice thing is it already comes up in top results, but if you wanted to filter by people, you can now do that in the full result set. So yes, we have brought full search results back. As a matter of fact, if we go back to our original John Wick example, and I go to top results, you can see that I can continue to scroll and get much more content related to my actual search terms. Let's go back. I think last but not least, well, actually, let's do a few more. So horror, I can now search for genres, as you can see here. But let's do a really cool example, which is my daughter is 5, and I want to find some great quality content for her to watch. I trust PBS Kids content, so let's do a quick search for that. And not only do I see that we have some PBS channels that I could check out and what's currently on those at the moment, but we also have the ability to search for services. So in this case, PBS Kids, I'm gonna go check that out. And immediately I can see all of these different views of the types of content that PBS has. Maybe it's because I already subscribed to this. Maybe it's because I see all this content, I'm interested in subscribing to it. But the fact of the matter is now you can use search as a discovery mechanism besides just trying to find the explicit title that you're looking for. All right, guys, thanks again for joining me. I really appreciate it. So that's our overview of the new features in search. There's tons of stuff I probably haven't covered, so come check us out in the forums. You can read more in the post, as well as chat with other users and us about search. We'd love to get your feedback. If there's something that you expect to work that's not, or there's some great positive results, we'd love to hear those too. We'll continue to update search transparently in the background, so hopefully it just continues to improve, and a lot of times we'll be able to do those improvements without media server or client releases. So look forward to that, and until next time, thank you.